In children is on the rise in the U.S.
Researchers say enterovirus D68 is showing up at a medium level in wastewater collection samples. Most infections cause little to no symptoms, but there can be a serious complication in children known as acute flaccid myelitis that causes muscles and reflexes to become weak and can even lead to paralysis. The Illinois Department of Public Health says it does not scan wastewater for enterovirus, but an independent testing agency says samples show medium rates in both the Glen Ellen and Wheaton areas.
Joining us now to discuss is Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Doctor, good to talk
good
to you. It's
to
been
see
a while.
Ya.
Good to see you.
Of course, it's good news we haven't talked to you in a while, but let's talk about this latest incident.
We talked about a couple other things as well. How serious is this, and how equipped are we to test for this? How necessary is that?
We don't look for it. It's not a reportable illness, and doctors are encouraged to report cases if they are appearing in a cluster. So it usually presents, there's some 10 to 15 million cases per year of, you know, just a typical cold type infection, just a respiratory disease. But in young kids who have never had it before, they can get this terrible event called acute flaccid myelitis, or AFM. And it's very similar to polio. The virus is related to the polio virus.
It's concerning when you hear about polio-like symptoms. Talk about why we're not on the alert about this like we would be about the spread of polio.
Robin, that is a really good question. It's not a reportable illness. And, you know, you have a private company, you have a private entity, you know, looking at the virus in wastewater. Well, if 10 to 15 million people a year get it, the wastewater is going to have it. And they're reporting moderate amounts. Okay, it's out there. This year, we've had some clusters, including here in Chicago, where they found something like 11 out of 14 tested cases were positive. It's actually even hard to make a diagnosis. You have to get the health department to actually do it or to send it to the Centers for Disease Control.
I think viewers assume that there's some agency locally or federally that says, oh my God, today we're gonna start doing this, or is that just not feasible?
Well, they're not equipped for it. They don't have the money for it. There's not enough money in public health. Now, a good thing that happened earlier this week as the U.S. government has funded a group called Revamp. It's $100 million a year to look at these emerging diseases that could cause a pandemic. So that's going to help. That started this week. So we have a way to go.
But put this in perspective for people. Is this something parents should be worried about? What percentage of kids not just get this, but maybe get those severe symptoms in case people are worried?
Well, the thing is, if a kid gets a cold, you know, it's probably just a regular cold. But if all of a sudden they start having droopy eyes or they start getting flaccid, you know, they're falling down, they can't walk or whatever, any kind of neurologic thing, immediately go to the hospital.
Okay. Can I just ask you before we let you go? I think there was a COVID outbreak over the summer. And so my question is there a new COVID booster that if we had it over the summer, we should get it in the fall? Where are we on this?
Yeah. So it looks like every summer we're getting these summer peaks of COVID. You know, we are at the sort of just the beginning of the downslope of that peak. Just yesterday in the United States is 136 deaths from COVID. So this has not gone away. That translates to 50,000 people per year, by the way. So it's coming down, though. The hospital rate is declining, even though we don't really measure that very well anymore either. But the number of cases is still pretty high, and the wastewater level is very high here in the Midwest and in the West. In other parts of the country, it's gone down to high from very high. So we're going down that wave right now. So there is a new vaccine. It's available now. Three companies, two mRNA companies and one traditional company, Novavax. So you can get it from any one of those. And that is geared toward the circulating virus right now. So people should get the new vaccine. They can get it at the same time they get the new flu vaccine, which is also available.
All right, Dr. Murphy, good to see you again. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, doctor.
Good to see you again.